Hey, welcome to the final in my series on the wet, dry, wet guitar rig that I'm using. The first video we looked at the pedal boards, and the second one we talked about the amplifiers. Today it's going to be a lot quicker. We're just going to focus on the rack and switching system I have. The heart of the system is this Switchblade GL here. That's an outstanding switching system. I should say routing system, because you can run effects in any order, parallel, series, doesn't matter. You can mix inputs, sum the inputs, and so forth. And very clean, noiseless unit. I can't say enough good things about it. Liquid Foot came out with a similar 1U type unit. Haven't got any experience with that, so I can't really comment on it. All the AC power is run by this rack rider here, which so I have a front panel main on and off. If I kind of try and get some light in here and pull this rack out, hopefully you'll be able to see how I power this. I'm powering it, everything on both trays, all the pedals, off a single Tidal Power 2 Plus supply. I don't have any noise issues. Way I help to ensure that is in cable routing. And I'll go into cable routing in another video, but basically I'm running all my DC along the outer edge here. This pedal, the Deja Vibe stereo here, and this old 80s flanger are run by AC. So all the AC runs along this outer edge here. All the signal runs up through the center. So I try and isolate any interaction between the various cables. So the pedals up here are all modulation. As you can see, I've got a POG 2, I've got this flanger I mentioned, and the stereo Deja Vibe. Here I have a Verbzilla, which I use for Octo and Cave. That's running in stereo. I also have an old 70s small stone and an 80s Ibanez stereo chorus. This particular unit is strictly for programming the Switchblade. The front panel is kind of a bear to use. It's not very user friendly. So what I do, I picked this up for 20, 30 bucks, whatever it was, I don't even remember, from Guitar Center, and I use their software to do all my presets. You can test with this, but it's actually a lot easier and a lot faster to use one of these units here. So that's pretty much it for that. The second tray is all dirt. I do have a compressor here, an old 80s DOD compressor. Everything else is dirt. You may recognize this unit back here. That is another one of those Leslie's clones that I built. I love those things, as you can tell. I also have a Formula Number 5 clone that I built here. I have an extra boost switch on it that I added. Again, all the DC is run along the outside. This is the only AC pedal in this tray. This is an old 80s TS-9. You probably recognize that. That's a DOD compressor, which gets a lot of bad press because of its breathing. And you can actually fix a lot of that. I actually changed the op amp in it and really cleaned up the signal, because before it was just very noisy and added a lot of noise to the signal. Not so much anymore. This is an old TU-2 tuner that I'm going to be getting rid of at some point. But this final pedal here is probably it's a real cool pedal. It was made back in the 80s. MTI made it, and MTI briefly owned Ampeg. So this particular pedal is all point-to-point wiring, and it's a full amplifier in the sense that it has a preamp and a power tube in it. And you can use it for headphones and such like that. I don't use it for that. I made a couple of modifications. So this is actually a preamp gain, and this is the post-amp master volume for it. And I also added a bypass indicator LED here. So the AC for that runs straight out the back. That's pretty much it for the rack system. Hope this was helpful for you, and as far as the signal routing goes. Again, all of these signals go up the center and tie into the switching system here. And the rack unit itself, as I mentioned before, connects to the amplifiers and it connects into the pedal board. So you can imagine there's some fairly long runs of cable, all of which are at least 15 to 20 feet long, as you can see down in here. Some of the cable routing. I'll get into that in a separate video on how to keep things quiet, and also give you a sound test on what this rig sounds like. Until then, thanks for joining me, and hope to see you in the next video.